Hi all, myself Feba Paul. I am going to present on the topic formwork for column, wall, beam and slab. We already studied about what is formwork. Formwork is a temporary mold into which concrete is poured and formed. It can be used for making slab, beam, lintel, column, foundation, etc. Formwork can be prepared and fabricated using timber and also can be constructed from steel, glass, fiber reinforced, plastic and other materials. First one is column formwork. As shown in the figure, column formwork consists of a box prepared from four separate sides. The four sides of the box are held by wooden blocks, bolt and yokes. Formwork should be designed to resist the high pressure resulting from the quick filling of the concrete. That is, it should be designed in such a way that it should resist the pressure resulting from the concrete filling. The main components of column formwork are sheeting all around the column periphery. We can see in the plan, the figure 1, and the side yokes and end yokes, two side yokes and two end yokes, wedges and bolt with washers. Depending upon the shape of the column, the box can be suitably prepared. As we seen the yokes, the spacing of the yoke is about 1 meter. They can be replaced by metal clamps of suitable design. We can also see a clean out hole at the bottom of the formwork to remove the debris which might have fallen before concrete placed. The sheeting of the column formwork is prepared from sheeting boards of planks, wooden planks, etc. And it is placed into a foot room which is anchored in the soil by steel bolts. When the sheeting panels have been inserted in the foot room, vertical arch timbers are placed to take the forces. And these arch timbers are surrounded by column clamps of steel, flat steel, which are clamped with wedges or a rim of boards. These column boxes should be designed such a way that it will take the little alteration that can be reused for columns with smaller cross section on upper floors. In order to make the dislocation of boxes easy, the nails that are given, that these are projected instead of being firmly driven. A wash of water is also given inside the formwork just before the laying of concrete. That's all about column formwork. Next one is wall formwork. Wall formwork consists of a vertically arranged upright timbers to which sheeting boards are nailed to the concrete side. We can see in the figure 3 that around the wall sheetings are provided. And this is diagonally braced by means of boards at both ends. Components of wall formwork include sheets, as we already told, studs, vertical studs and veils, horizontal veils, ties and the support braces. The sheets are supported by vertical studs and horizontal veils as given in the figure 4. Ties are also provided to maintain the distance between sheets and to resist the bursting action of concrete. We can also provide a small pieces of timber known as paces. Instead of that, we can also provide ties and bolts. These tie wires are placed at a horizontal distance about 600 mm. And they are taken around the veils. Veils are horizontal beams. When formwork is struck off, the ends of the wire ties are cut off and provided with rich quality of cement mortar to avoid rusting. If bolts are used, they are to be provided with the grease so that it can be easily removed after 2 or 3 days. Braces may be provided at a horizontal distance of about 2 meters. They are supported at ground level by stakes, as we can see in this figure. the wall is high, guy wires are provided instead of braces. As we see in the column firmware, here also cleaning holes are provided. Next one is beam and slab formwork. This beam formwork has prefabricated formwork sheeting in the bottom and also in the side panels. These are manufactured according to specification. The major components are cleats, joist or batten, ledgers, side forms, bottom sheeting and head tree. The sheeting bottom and the side panel consists of sheeting boards nailed together by means of cover straps. We can see in this figure. Sheeting bottom can be placed on round timber with a cleat connection. The round timber is located at the center of the beam. The slab formwork sheeting lies on a squared timber formwork beams which are arranged on main beams carrying off the forces to round timber columns. That is, slab formwork is connected to main beams. The joists support the deck of the slab. Next is ledgers. These ledgers are horizontal wooden pieces nailed to cleats. They form the bearing for joist. Next is about head tree. We see the head tree. The whole of the beam is supported on a head tree. It is a horizontal beam connected at the top of the vertical post through cleats. At the bottom of the vertical post, a pair of wedges are placed over sole pieces. Wedges help in tightening or slightly raising the formwork to develop initial camber in the formwork. In this topic, we studied about what is formwork, different types of formwork such as column formwork, wall formwork, beam and slab formwork, its main components and its functions. Thank you.